Yeah, so obviously the depth is kind of a key on the defensive line. So what have you seen out of the first couple days, the first day of
JB, has Ian Victor been
there? I thought today was great. They came out with some focus. You know, obviously the depth is a good thing that we have. But we still need to get better, and that is better in technique, better in scheme. Trying to learn more than one position so we can rotate throughout the depth. So we'll continue to do that and get better every day.
And with that depth, how much does it help early on in the fall to kind of be able to maybe save some guys and not burn everyone out right away and kind of space?
It's kind of twofold. I mean, one, yes, you know, to have the depth and be able to rotate people and keep as fresh as you can and have somebody go full speed and then tap out and the next person will go. That's a great thing about it. But also because of how much they can grasp in terms of our package, we'll be able to play, you know, start the person that knows and move them to end and move them out to tackle. So it makes it even better in terms of how much we can move and mix and match.
And then Vita, they having a guy 6'3", 250, I don't know what he is now, but how much of a treat is it to have a guy like that on the defensive line to really anchor in the middle of it?
Great. You know, like, he is really, we have so many components to our front, you know, and it helps because of our backers and our defensive backs and what they allow us to do. With him just moving forward and getting better in technique, I think you'll see great things from him, but it also got to start from day one. So, you know, we're happy and pleased with what he's done today, but we still got much more to gain throughout the camp.
As far as when you talk about technique,
yeah,
and you know, this is your first fall camp, your spring ball. Are you teaching a different technique than what Coach Cho was teaching before, or is it just kind of a continuation?
It's really a continuation. There might be some tweaks in it. Really, the language is what we kind of went through in spring. My language trying to get to their language and me learning it, you know, as opposed to their learning mine. But it was really done all the same. You know, we're just going to continue doing what they've done already. Not to say that the package is broken, it's not. But to keep going forward and moving forward and adding on some stuff to tweak, hopefully we can get better in our techniques, you know, using our hands, using our feet, knowing our eyes, those types of stuff.
Have the months, I guess, just between spring and fall, giving you more of a time to adjust, I guess, just from what Coach Cho's personality was to what yours is? I mean, obviously you had all of spring. What do you say during that time, even though there wasn't necessarily camp going on?
Absolutely.
You guys were able to develop a relationship.
No question. You know, that was a huge deal. And that's actually really part of Coach Peterson's Built for Life. It's a relationship, you know. So my job was to try to establish, I should say, a relationship with all of them, you know, and let them know how much I care for them individually off the field and eventually to carry on the field. So the off season was really huge for us in terms of building relationships. Now we're back in season, we're back to fundamentals and learning technique.
And personally for you, how does it feel to finally be back for a fall at Husky Stadium and back wearing this purple and gold again?
It's awesome. You know, I'm very honored to be back wearing the purple and gold. I'm honored that Coach Peterson has given me a chance and been working with the guys that I work with on defense. Really excited to match up the old with the new and then together moving over to the future. You know, I know Husky fans are really excited what's going on and what they're seeing, but hopefully we can follow through with that thought.